Hello and welcome back. My name is Xander. Welcome to the Nginx Mastery series. This tutorial, very simple, we're going to configure basic password authentication. So the scenario is that we have an endpoint of some sort, maybe some sort of location that we want to secure via a password. We're going to go ahead and create a password file and then set a username and password and then apply that to a location block. There is a link in the video description which would take you to the code for this series. Now we are going to start from part 8 from the code that you'll find in part 8. If you have missed any of the other tutorials, have a look at the channel, go to the playlist, you'll find the Nginx Mastery series. Just before we get started, an end note, we will be utilizing Docker, so it is expected that you have Docker Desktop installed. It is available on Mac, Windows, and Linux. Go ahead and download that if you want to follow along step by step. So I've gone ahead and downloaded part 8, loaded it up in Visual Studio Code here. This is what you can see on the left-hand side, and have Docker Desktop installed, and it's completely clear, completely fresh, no images or containers. So I won't go through this step by step because I'm making the assumption that you've seen the other tutorials in this series. So let's get rid of that. You can see that we have a Docker Compose file, which is going to build three containers, a web container, Nginx, and DNS. I still haven't uploaded that file. So just to get this working, we are going to need a .env file here. So create a new folder, .env, and then a new file inside of there. That was called dev.env. Just a few environment variables for Django to run. Is irrelevant if you are new to Django. It's just there, just for us to showcase Nginx. So secret key, you can just utilize something very simple like this very quickly. Okay, so that should sort it out and that should work okay. Right, so once that's done, we can then go ahead and just Docker compose this. And then just up, and that's just going to build all the containers that we're going to need to then run our new configuration. So everything should be running now. I do have Docker, apologies, I've told you this in every single version, every single tutorial. I do have Docker extension here. You can see that the containers are running okay. So we should be able to test that out. So let's give that a go. So that's run on just a local host, so no port required. And you can see that Django is running. We can just have a show the test page, and there we go. So everything is working fine. So this is essentially a two-step process. First of all, we need to build a username and password file, and then we can go ahead and configure our password for a particular location. So we can do that in the location block. We can definitely apply a password in a location block, and in addition to that, we go into the config file here, we can also apply it more generally, but we're going to be utilizing it within a location block. So for this to work, we are going to need to use htpasswd, and that basically manages user files for basic authentication of HTTP users. So we're going to need to create this htpasswd file, and in order to do that, if my memory serves me right, we're going to need the Apache 2 utils for that. So I am going to run an installation. So I could update the Docker file here. I could update, okay. So in actual fact, let's update this Docker file. So when we create the image, we also need to install, we can install Apache 2 utils, which is going to then allow us to then create or utilize htpasswd. Right, so let's just do a run, a new run. We could extend the one that already exists, right? But let's just use apt-get install. Let's go for no install recommends. Use the Y flag and then Apache 2 utils. There we go, something like that. Okay, so that's going to install the Apache 2 utils, and that's going to then allow us to create our password file. So because we've done that, we are going to need to rebuild the container. And again, I'm assuming you're new to this, utilizing Docker. So I'm just going to use the dashboard. I'm going to go ahead and just, I don't need to, I'm just going to delete all the containers and all the images and just start completely fresh. Okay, right. So let's go back. We'll just get rid of that. Open up our shell again. So let's go for the Docker Compose again. And then up. So that's going to build and load our containers. Okay, so we've got failed here. Okay, I've added too many, haven't I? That's why. Okay, apologies. All right, let's go back. So there should be two dashes, not three. So it looks like everything is working okay now. So just go back into my Docker extension here. And you can see all the containers are up and running. So I apologize, I'm not trying to annoy you. I've forgotten another step. So let's make a folder so that we can actually store our password file. So again, inside of the Nginx folder here, Docker file, let's go ahead and create a new folder. I'm using the p flag, and that's going to allow me to build, go across new directories, utilize multiple directories. So let's just go for home, let's put this inside the etc folder, and we'll create a new folder called pwd. There we go. So let's go ahead and do that. So apologies, you're just gonna need to restart again. Don't need to do this, but just to keep everything nice and fresh, and like I said, assuming that you're completely new, let's just go ahead and remove. There is a command that we can flush this if you want to learn that. Okay, so let's try this again. So this time we're going to recreate our containers and now create a new folder. Okay, let's give this a go. Okay, so let's go back into, assume you've got this installed or extension here, and we should be able to go into the files. Let's just drop all this down, and we're going to etc, and we should have a new folder in here called so it's just here. Okay, so that's the new folder we just created. So that's where we're going to create our new passwords or our password file. Right, so we're going to need to go into our container for this. So using the extension, I can just right click and attach the shell, and I can now work within this container very easily. So having installed what we've installed here, we should now be able to use htpasswd. Yeah, and let's go for /etc/pwd. And then we're going to create a new file called htpasswd. And then we're going to make a new user1. So we need to add a new password. So I'm just going to call this user1. So that's the password. And there we go. So we've now made a new password for them. And we can go in and check this file. We may as well have a look. So we can do that through the terminal here, or in this case, I'm just showing you this manually if you're not familiar with utilizing the terminal. So inside of here, we've got the password folder. We've just made a new file. That's the new file we just created. So let's have a look, and you can see what's happened. We create a new user, and that's our password. So we can see that the password is encrypted. Now you can go ahead and read the docs for this. There's different ways to encrypt this password. I think bcrypt, MD5, or you can utilize one of the SHA-1, for example. So that's kind of irrelevant. The fact is it's been encrypted at this point. So we now have a username and password set up, and we can now use this file to go ahead and secure a location. So let's go ahead and just close all this. And I'm just gonna go back to the file explorer here and then go into Nginx config and our configuration. Right, so with that in place, let's go ahead now, and this is really the simplistic part here, the simple part. Right, so we're going to pick a location. So let's go ahead and set a location. So that location is going to be test. So we did have a test URL. That's already been set up in Django. Again, we don't need to know too much about that. We've got a URL that we want to secure. Right, so we just pass all this in so we can get this working. That's kind of irrelevant. But here we've set up, if you're not familiar with this, we've set up a reverse proxy here over to Django. And Django is being served by the unicorn. Okay, so with that in place, let's just go for some basic configurations. Basic configuration even. So we can set a name for this. So let's just call this secure area. And then let's go ahead and use auth basic user file. Okay, so that's going to be found. We just need to define where that is found, etc., password, and then the file. And that's it. Okay, so let's give this a go. So back in my browser, I'll just go back into the homepage. Yep, okay. And then we go to the test location, and you can see, in actual fact, nothing is working at this point. And that's obviously because we've not then refreshed, or we've not told Nginx to utilize this new configuration. It's still using the old configuration. Right, so two ways we can do this. We can go into the console and reload. We're using Docker, so it makes it a lot easier for us to just right-click, restart our Nginx container, and then give it another go. So this time, go to, it's not working this time. It looks like there's a problem. Okay. Looks like there's a problem. So our container's not come up. Let's have a look at the configurator. Oh, obviously, I'm going too quickly. Apologies. So we need the semicolons at the end. So let's just start this up. Okay, so we're up and running now. Let's try that again. And then let's go into test. And there we go. So we're looking for user one. And the password is user one. And there we go. So there we have a basic configuration, configuring basic password authentication on a location endpoint. Now, of course, there are many different ways of configuring security with Nginx, and we will explore that in future tutorials. But for now, hopefully that was useful, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.